Hello everyone, our today's topic is how to import data into Microsoft Dynamics. Today we'll talk about how to import data via application, via import wizard, or using Power Platform. Whether you are using sales application or customer service application or field service application or marketing application, all are modern driven apps. So process to import data is same everywhere. Let's jump to demo directly. We have the CSV file, very simple file with only one column, name and name of the companies. And we want to import this data into Dynamics CRM or Dynamics Sales. Go to Accounts, Import from Excel, Import from CSV. Choose file, next, keep option default, allow duplicate, yes or no as per your requirement. And please notice, first row contain column headings. Review mappings. In source file, the name of column is name, but in Dynamics Sales, the name of entity is the account, and the field name is account name. So it is not mapped. So we have to choose proper mapping. Now all good to go. Click on finish. And click on track progress. You can see your import is in progress. Let's refresh it. It's complete. Click on accounts. You can see now these five accounts are present in our system. In case you want to roll back the operation, we can also do that. Go to Power Platform, Settings, and click on Imports. You can see this operation is here. You can select this. All record imported to this entity during this import. Click on this option. Click on OK. Go back to accounts, click on refresh. All the five accounts that we imported earlier are removed from system. This is the simplest way to import or remove data from the system after import. Let's take a complex example. This is a file of contacts. In contact entity, we have name, last name, phone number. We don't have any attribute like continent. So we have to create a continent attribute as well. Payment terms. By default, we have net 45, net 60, net 30 items in the default sales application, but not the net 71. And also, contact have parent account, which is Tata, IBM, Microsoft. Please note that the account can have multiple contacts, but a contact can have only one single account as a parent account. So relationship is one to many between account to contact. So we have to import this data into CRM now. Let's go to contacts. You can see continent not mapped. And we need able to find the option of create new attributes because we are using the application as end user, and for this kind of activities we need admin level permissions. So we'll do this job from import wizard. Power Platform, settings, click on imports. Import data, choose the file, next. So you want to import data into which entity? Contact, next, continent not mapped. Let's create a new field. As we can see that continent is predefined set of values. So we'll choose over here. Option set. Okay. Phone number not mapped. We'll map this to business phone. Payment terms. So we map a new item NAT7 with the NAT7 in the target system, which is Dynamics 365 over here. Parent account. As I mentioned, relationship between account and contact is one to many. So parent account is a kind of lookup field. If you go to contacts, it's a lookup kind of field. And system name of account name is company name under schema. Choose company name over here, lookup, choose account. Click OK. Click Next. Next. Review settings and import data. You can give the name of mapping if you want to use the same mapping in future. Submit. Finish. It's parsing. It's completed now. Let me go back to contacts. Still there are no contacts. Let's recheck what's the reason behind this. Click on first import. Click on failure. You can see here there are 5 entries under failure. The lookup reference could not be resolved. As I mentioned earlier, this value, the parent account for this contact, is under 1-to-N relationship. So before creating child, parent should exist. If we refer, we have no accounts like Tata, IBM, Microsoft, Universal System. So first of all, we have to make sure accounts exist before creation of contacts. This is the reason our last import failed. So let me create accounts over here or import of account over here. Now we have accounts in place. Let's try the same contract import now. We can use our contract mapping which we have saved earlier. Let's wait for success. You can see that we have our accounts in our system. We have this parent account. We have new entry NAT7 over here. But what about this field continent? By default, import process create the attribute but does not show on the form by default. If you want to show on the form, you have to bring it by customization. For example, to tables, now you can see continent is also visible over here. So with the help of import wizard, you can do very complex import process as well. There's one more way to import records. Go to make.powerapps.com. Go to table and import data. You can use URL from OneDrive. Upload file from here. And try out different kind of mappings. So we learnt over here how to import data into Dynamics, sales or marketing or customer service or field service or any model driven app using various methods. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you liked it. I will be happy to solve your queries further. Please mention in comment box or over my website, which I have given in description. Please subscribe to my channel to see such demonstrations. Thank you.